Did you ever have everything you ever wanted, but still felt really sad and unsatisfied? That was me about 3 years ago. I had the house, I had the husband, I had my beautiful daughter, and I just felt an unsatisfaction in my life for no real reason. I tried drinking it away, I tried distractions, I tried vacations, and nothing really worked until I hit bottom when my mom passed away. And when I hit bottom, I literally could not move off the couch. I was really scared because my limbs just felt like I could barely lift them. And I really was in crisis mode. I took a week off work. I work in finance full time. And I just regrouped and I decided to stop drinking and to really take a strong look at my life and see what was going on with me. In that, when I did that, I rediscovered my writing because I've always wanted to be a writer and that is my passion. And through my writing, I got in touch with my creative side and I started painting again. And I haven't painted since I was maybe a teenager, maybe in high school, but I started drawing women. And the women I drew represented how I felt. This is one of the women I drew and painted, and it's acrylic paint on canvas. And I just started putting all my feelings on to my canvases. This is another one I painted. And these are just painted within the last year and a half. Actually, these have been painted in the last month or so. So my original paintings were, I would say not very good in my opinion, but, then I just kept on doing it every single day, basically. I just painted and painted because that was my therapy. I just felt so much better when I was painting and I would just meditate. Here's another one I did for Christmas. And she's acrylic on canvas and they're all original designs. If you notice, they all have one thing in common with me right now, which is they all are wearing a crown. And through my journey that I started to realize that as a woman, we get so tied up in what our family wants and what is expected of us, we forget about ourselves and we forget about our power as women. And so as I started to paint and write, I have a weekly blog that I do every Saturday morning, I realized I'd been forgetting a huge part of myself, and no wonder I was depressed, and no wonder I was searching, because I forgot about the very power within me. So my journey ended up creating beautiful queens. And here's my Christmas queen. Excuse me, I'm the one-man show here. So there's my Christmas queen. Here's another one of my Christmas queens. And they all represent different moods, different times of being a woman. And I think we forget about that as we go through life, especially as we get into midlife and we just say, oh, well, you know, I'll just, you know, count out my days until retirement and until I have grandchildren. But there's a whole nother level that we can achieve. And that's what I'm here to remind every single woman who is middle-aged or younger or older or whoever you are, is that you have a power within you that is amazing. And when you tap it, wonderful things can happen. That is what I'm about. That is my message. And that is what my art is about. Is that all women are born queens and we just need to be reminded every once in a while of our power and tap into it because it's the most beautiful thing in the world and it saved my life.